Hello again, I'm Dustin Kirkland and I'm joined this time by Ian Lewis, developer advocate at Google. He's going to tell us a little bit about a new open source container isolation sandbox called gVisor.
Right. So gVisor is a sandbox isolation project for containers. It provides a lightweight execution mode for containers, but also gives you very secure isolation between those containers.
It's really all about the security, isn't it?
Exactly. So for things like containers, they provide isolation in the form of namespaces and C groups and as a feature of the Linux kernel. But you are exposed to kernel bugs and things like that, and unforeseen issues with regard to the Linux kernel. And so if any sort of new bug happens or that type of thing, a zero day happens, you are exposed to that. And so what this does is it actually helps you to mitigate those type of issues.
Right. It reduces the surface, as I understand it, right?
Right. So it actually provides a separate layer in between the running application and the Linux kernel.
And what is that layer?
So that layer is actually a user space implementation or a user space kernel.
Okay.
So to be a little bit detailed, it implements a lot of Linux or most of the Linux syscalls and then provides user space virtualization for the container.
Cool. And you've got a demo for us here today. Tell us a little bit about this demo and how it's going to work.
Yeah, so this particular demo is going to show a kernel vulnerability. And what we're going to do is we're going to show how that vulnerability can be used to break out of the container and then out of a normal container that's a Linux container that's using namespaces, and how that can actually be mitigated when using something like, or when using gVisor.
Okay, and this is a real vulnerability, not something that you've instrumented.
Right, this is a vulnerability that has since been patched, obviously, but it's one that, if it was released today,
would have been protected better by gVisor.
By gVisor, exactly.
Interesting.
So what we are going to do is we're going to take advantage of the dirty cow vulnerability in the Linux kernel. What I have here is a OCI image, or an OCI bundle. And in the configuration, here we've got the UID and GID set to a user. And here we're going to run a dirty cow vulnerability. And this is going to write to a file that is controlled by root from a user, from within a container. So when they run this using runc, this takes a little while, but what's happening here is that we are doing a couple of syscalls in parallel in order to trigger a race condition in the Linux kernel. And that's going to allow us to write to a file that's controlled by root and effectively get a privilege escalation. Okay, so the exploit has run, and so what we're going to do here is we're going to check the file that we were going to write to. So here we were trying to write to the password file. In this case, our particular exploit wrote to the beginning of the password file. So here you can imagine that you could write in an entirely new line for our root user and give it a new password and essentially get privilege escalation. Okay, so what we're going to do here is we're going to run the exact same vulnerability in the gVisor sandbox. So here I have the exact same OCI bundle. So we'll look at the config. Here we have the exact same user ID setup, UID and GID, as well as the same exploit that we're going to try to run here. And so what we'll do is we'll use the run sc command to invoke gVisor, and we will run this with the ptrace and strace commands. And what this will do is allow us to see the syscalls that are being made by the exploit. And here we can see a lot of debug. This particular exploit is calling these syscalls in a loop, in a tight loop, in two different threads. And so we can see syscalls being made here and intercepted by gVisor. And because we have this extra layer between the application and the Linux kernel here that gVisor provides, we can intercept those and prevent the vulnerability from actually happening. So now we've dropped out of that command, and we're going to just take a look at our password file to see if it was actually been written to. So here we're going to look at the contents of the file, and we can see here that the exploit was not actually able to write to the file.
So that's super interesting, actually. If a user is interested in downloading gVisor, maybe running it today, what's the minimum requirements? How does someone get started?
So right now we have, it's a normal open source project. So we have that, it's released on GitHub. So you can check that out and compile and run gVisor on your own. It's very similar in the end to Run-C in the sense that it provides two things. It provides a kind of a library that you can use to run sandbox containers, as well as a command called run-sc, which is very similar to Run-C in the sense that it's a drop-in kind of replacement for Run-C. So you can use things like Docker to actually run a container.
Okay, great. And if someone wants to contribute to this project, it's an open source project, and as much as Kubernetes is an open source project.
Sure, absolutely. So you can contribute to the project by engaging with us like through GitHub and submitting issues and patches there, joining kind of in the kind of community by providing feedback through GitHub.
That's great. Thanks,
awesome.
Ian.